Today we're going to have a look at calibrating and measuring with a micrometer caliper. This particular caliper is a 0 to 1 inch micrometer caliper. The very first thing we want to do when we are checking the calibration is we want to clean the measuring points, which from the last video you know as an anvil and a spindle. So I'm going to take a piece of paper and I'm going to put it between the anvil and the spindle, and I'm just going to turn the thimble down so we get contact with the paper, and I'm going to drag it off the part. Now I'm going to put my hand back on the ratchet stop and click and have the anvil and spindle meet each other and give it a slight little click. I'm going to zoom in and see if we can have a look at the size. What I'd like you to notice is the zero on the thimble does not line up with the zero on the datum. As discussed before, in the back there is this little hole which we can put a wrench in. I'm going to take the wrench and I'm going to put it into this little hole in the back here, and we're just going to move it until the two zeros line up. So again, this sleeve is a friction fit and I can turn it by putting the wrench in the back. So hopefully now you can see that the two zeros are in line with each other. Now that I know they're in line, we can proceed to measure with it. Because this is a 0 to 1 inch micrometer, the anvil and the spindle are going to touch each other. And again, any micrometer will have a range of 1 inch. So 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, or 25 millimeters. 0 to 25 millimeter where the anvil and spindle will touch. 25 to 50 millimeters where they will be apart. So here is a 1 to 2 inch micrometer. Again, any micrometer will measure with the range of 1 inch. So what I would have to do with this one is we would have to clean the measuring faces. And in the box, when you purchase your micrometer, there will be a standard. This one here will be exactly 1 inch. So if I clean both of these measuring faces, we open the thimble up a little bit, and we put the standard in between it, lock it, and we can check the size here. And this one here looks very good, so it doesn't need calibration. Now that we know the tool is calibrated, we can go ahead and we can start to measure with it. The principle that this tool is built on, so what I've done is I've pulled a micrometer apart, and hopefully you can see this, there's a thread inside here. There are 40 threads to the inch. And we have an inch scale here on the sleeve. 40 threads to the inch. So if I give the thimble one complete revolution, it would move the micrometer 1/40th of an inch. If you take with your calculator and put in 1 inch divided by 40 and hit enter, the number should be 0.025, or what we would call 25 thou. So each graduation on the main scale will equal 25 thou. So you produce this part, and now we're going to measure it. So we're going to take the micrometer and we're going to open it up. Again, this one's already been calibrated and cleaned, so we're good to go. And we're just going to put it across the part. I'm bringing the thimble down so we're close to the part. And then I'm going to move my fingers up to the ratchet stop and give it a couple of clicks. And we'll lock this knurled ring, this lock nut. Now, we'll zoom in and we'll see if we can have a look at this and figure out what's going on with the measurement. Okay. So, if we look at this, again, the main scale is graduated. Every line is 25 thou or 1/40th of an inch. Every fourth line is actually numbered or 1/10th of an inch. So this would be, this one here would be the first decimal place, 0.100, or what we would call 100 thou. Again, each small graduation is 1/40th of an inch. I asked you to put it in your calculator, and the answer should have been 0.025, or 25 thou. So what we want to do is we want to read it off the datum line, which is running horizontal, and we want to follow it all the way back to the thimble. So I can see in this example, I can just see the 5, or 0.500 inches, 500 thou. That's as fine as the main scale can read to. Each one of these graduations, being 25 thou, this one would be 400, 425, 450, 475, 0.500, or half inch. And then we would look onto the thimble and see what number we have on this. In this case, you'll notice that the zero lines up with the datum line are very, very close to it. So the answer for the size of that part we just measured would be 0.500, 500 thou, 500 thousandths of an inch, or if we look at the fractional size, it would be half inch. Let's try another one. So we have this screw, and we just want to measure the outside diameter of it. Again, we're going to bring the anvil and the spindle down so it contacts the screw, and then we're just going to move the ratchet stop a couple of clicks and lock it. We'll pull the part out being measured, and we'll check the measurement. And again, we'll zoom in on this. Okay. So if you have a look at this, I'm just going to make a very small adjustment here. So if we have a look at the scale here, again, looking across the datum, I'm seeing the 0.1, I'm seeing the 0.2. Again, each graduation past that is 25 thou, so we have 0.200, or 200 thou, plus, can you see one graduation on the sleeve past the 200 thou? Again, that's 25 thou. So 0.200, 200 thou, plus 0.025 should be 0.225, or 225 thou. You'll notice it's not quite to the second graduation on the sleeve past the 200 thou. So this is where the thimble comes into play. Each graduation on the thimble is 0.001 inches. In other words, we've taken 1 inch and divided it 1,000 times. So each graduation, the smallest this will read, is 0.001 inches. So again, going back to the sleeve, 100 thou, 200 thou, 225. Now we have to go to the thimble and count them. And you will notice the 20 lines up. So again, 0.200 plus 0.025 on the sleeve plus 0.020. So if you add those together, the answer should be 0.245 inches, or 245 thou. That would be the outside diameter of this screw. Now, you will notice I made a very small adjustment because I wanted to talk about that first. And this mic was actually sitting just a little bit less than 245 thou. So in this case, it would be 244 thou, being the 19, and a little bit. You'll notice we're between the two graduations on the thimble in relationship to the datum line across a micrometer. So what I would do is I would read the first three decimal places on this mic. So again, 100, 200, so 0.200 inches, 25 thou past that, 0.025. Then I would go to the thimble and we would look at it, and there's 19 on that. So this would be 0.244 inches and a little bit. Now, this micrometer actually has a vernier scale. So what we would do is tilt it up and we would have a look at the top. And what I'm looking for is any number that lines up. So if we have a look, it looks to me like the 6 lines up. So this number here with the 3 is, I don't care about that. I'm just going to follow it all the way to the front and I can see the six lines up. This becomes the fourth decimal place. So the answer for this micrometer reading would be 0.2446. 244 thou and 6 tenths of a thou.